Hi, betting experts. On Saturday the 10th of April, we're going to take a look now at every race on Grand National Day at Aintree. The ground, good to soft. They've been watering to maintain. The weather set fair. It's a cracking day's racing. Obviously, the highlight at 5:15, but hopefully we've found some other winners on the rest of the card. We start off with the 145. This is the EFT Systems Handicap Hurdle. 3 miles, 149 yards, grade 3, class 1, 4-year-olds and up. Was £31,500 on offer to the winner. The one I like here is Champagne Platinum of Nicky Henderson's. Now, this 7-year-old has run 6 times over hurdles, winning twice. They tried chasing with him last season. That didn't work out at all. He's been running himself back into form after 261 days off, finishing a cracking third in a competitive handicap on good ground at Newbury over 2 mile 4, then upped to 3 miles, bumping into Bushy Park at Haydock. The winner, a prolific front runner who's destroyed fields all winter, and at Cheltenham, well backed, finished 5th behind Mrs. Milner. I thought shaped pretty well in that Potemps final there. Under a patient ride, just getting tired up the hill. I think he'll do a lot better on a flatter track on decent ground, and he should go really close 23 days later. The 225, the Betway Mersey Novice Hurdle, 2 mile 4, grade 1, class 1 for 4-year-olds and upwards, £42,000 on offer to the winner. This is the betting expert nap of the day, My Drogo of Dan Skelton. Now, this one comes from a yard in blistering form, 26% strike rate in the last fortnight, 3 from 3 over hurdles so far, a slow run race at Newbury in November, impressive on testing ground at Ascot in December, and then upped in class to a Kelso Grade 2 and storming home to land the premier novice hurdle there in style under Harry Skelton. This is another step up in class, but I think the extra 2 furlongs will suit him. He's going to be a cracking 3-mile chaser in time. He's held in the highest regard. He's improving as his stamina is drawn out, and I think they'll be mortified if he gets beaten. He's going to be a really nice horse over the next few years for the Skeltons. The 3 o'clock, the Doombar Magpul Novice Chase, 2 mile grade 1, class 1, 5-year-olds and upwards. Shishkin scared off most of the opposition here. It's going to be very long odds on and extremely hard to beat. Just been flawless so far. 4 from 4 over fences, jumps like Sprinter Sacra. Nico de Boinville barely moved for him to land the Arkle. In style, he's going to be a very short price and will win bar a fall. The 335, the Ryanair Stayers Hurdle, a cracking contest, grade 1, 3 miles, 85 grand nearly on offer to the winner. I think this is a good opportunity for Paisley Park. He got tapped, parked wide at Cheltenham, lost his place before staying on again up the hill. I don't think he was seen to best effect there. I understand they're going to front run here and try and avoid hitting that flat spot that keeps proving costly for him at the highest level recently. He will love this track on decentish ground, and I think Time Hill has had a major problem and missed Cheltenham. It's a bit of a leap of faith with him that Hobbs will be able to get him back, and it has to be said that Philip Hobbs not exactly flying in the last few weeks. He's 0 from 31 at the time of recording, so that has to be a concern for Time Hill. Paisley Park for me, hopefully make all and see them all off. The 4:15, the Betway Handicap Chase, a cracking grade 3, over 3 miles, 210 yards, class 1, £31,500 on offer to the winner. I really like Hold the Note, who I thought ran an absolute screamer at Cheltenham until weakening out of things up the hill. He has now run 10 times over fences without winning, but he's been in very deep, and it looked like the wind operation had worked when he finished second behind Enrillo at Newbury in February. He should go really well. Tom Scudamore's in the saddle, having been ridden by Jonathan Burke a couple of times this season. I'm hoping this flat track on decentish ground will suit him ideally. He's a very sound jumper. I think he'll make a real bold bid. The 5:15, the Grand National, well, 4 mile 2, grade 3, class 1, 7-year-olds and up, was £375,000 on offer to the winner. I've long liked Cloth Cap. It has to be said that we've mentioned him over the last few months on various broadcasts and podcasts. When he was 16 and 14 to 1, he's now crashed right down to 4 to 1. He is my selection. I think he's by far the most likely winner, but it has to be said he's a short enough price now in a race of this nature. I'm not worried about the trip. He's a brilliant jumper. He needs decent, good ground. Perhaps the watering that they've put on the course to make sure it's good to soft is a slight negative for his chance at the prices, but he ran really well when he was tried at 4 miles in the Scottish Grand National previously, so I'm not worried about 4 mile 2. He's going to make a bold bid. He reminds me very much of Mr. Frisk, who won the 1990 Grand National, for those of us who are old enough to remember. He's a sound jumper. He's uncomplicated. He's going to give Tom Scudamore a real thrill. And the 6:20 to to finish us off, the bumper over 2 miles, not a betting race for me, a token selection, Charlie's Glance of Andrew Martin, who really impressed when landing a long odds gamble late at Newbury back in March, quickening up smartly there to win with any amount in hand. I think if he was trained by anyone else, he'd be a lot shorter price. So he's a token selection in a really hard race to finish things off. Best of luck on Saturday at Aintree, Betting Experts.